likely making plenty of adjustments after that first half of football. So for the call of the second half here in week one, we go back to Brandon and Charles.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. Oh, good return up past the 30. Past midfield. Still going. He's the bulldozer. And he will score. Touchdown.
Talk about taking words and bringing them to life. At halftime, I will guarantee you in their locker room, they talked about pressing the kicking game because you can get an advantage if you do it right, and they just did.
Gay is on for the point after. And that one makes this a 19-point game. And no doubt one of the most, if not the most, exciting play we'll see in this game. The kick return all the way to the end zone for 6 points. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff.
Taking it about the one.
And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. So here are the Bears now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on four, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
but he
up.
Trusted his defense. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Of five there as the safety blitz winds up paying off.
Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack.
Yeah, that's one where you turn to your lineman and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely because, remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
Throwing on third down, Fields.
He's going to wind up and air it out. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. A good kick, 49 yards, just three on the return.
The offense for Los Angeles returns to the field.
They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
And quickly, they get to the line. From the 41, Stafford for a right side. Going to be taken in by Henderson. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Now it's Stafford, sliding out of the pocket. Oh, now he'll try and chuck it deep left side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
They've been trying and trying, but they haven't sacked him yet. He's been able to get away and make plays. Tried to make another one downfield right there, but to no avail. They'll have to keep up the pursuit, though, and not let him get hot.
Open man right side is cut complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 33. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Throwing again at Stafford. Eluding the pressure right.
And oh, that nearly their first pick of the game. But it falls down to the ground incomplete.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Meanwhile, Stafford's throw here, hauled in by Kupp.
And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
Stafford, they'll roll him out right. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4.
Second down, ball on the 3. First down marker at the 1-yard line.
And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Fourth touchdown pass of the game for Matthew Stafford. And the Rams add on to their lead.
So this looking more and more like it is going to be a successful kickoff to their campaign as they add on here.
And pardon me, you know NFL coaches, they're on the sideline thinking about all the little things that need correcting. But for the most part, they've got to be ecstatic with the way this season has started out.
Extra point by Gain is up and good. And that will bump the lead up to 26. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Here's Cohen now to return. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. And now the Bears coming out as they get ready. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
To Montgomery on second down.
And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. These guys have punted four times already and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And this will get inside the 20 and be touchdown just outside of the 15-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
Now a first down throw, Stafford. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating the defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage. Able to knock that one away.
And that almost their first INT of the ball game. Had his sights on it, but he couldn't seal the deal. Here's Stafford rolling to his right. Oh, he's going to go for it all. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown. Cooper Kupp with now three week one touchdowns. And the Rams get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. Well, sometimes you just got to marvel at how these guys can throw the football. He gave that everything he had, and it was right on the money.
And that is absolutely demoralizing for a defense because you've got the offense on the ropes. It's third down. You're trying to get off the field, and then wham, you have a letdown in the secondary, and you give up a big one.
Yeah, and that throw, my goodness, and even 70 yards through the air. Extra point by Gain is up and good, and the lead will swell by one more. Following the touchdown, here's Gain to kick it away. Here's Cohen now to return. And he returns this to the 22. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They are right now just
ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first down, it's Montgomery. Down the numbers. There he goes. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. David Montgomery, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Bears cut into that lead. Santos able to tack on the extra point. And that trims the lead a bit, but still standing at 26 points. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Jackson now to return. And able to get this out to the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Launches deep. The jump ball, and this is caught. And he's finally taken down, but not before he reaches the 14. A big play there for L.A. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. A quick throw caught by Kupp out wide. Touchdown, Rams! Cooper Kupp, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Rams are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. And let's count them up now. 1, 2, 3, 4 touchdown receptions for him in this game.
And just one shy of the NFL record. What a great performance. Throwing up and catching the football, creating space, and finding the end zone. That's what it's all about.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that will extend this big lead. The long touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tidy 2-play drive that time. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Here's Cohen now to return. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. David Montgomery ready to take the field for the Bears' next possession. He's already hit pay dirt twice. He's up over 100 yards. He is feeling good.
And he's just zipping along today. Everything coming together for him. It's that type of a day that you see a back just kind of have a grin on his face every time his number is called. Because he doesn't feel like there's going to be any lost yardage plays. Nothing but big-time positive runs.
Making the sideline grin as well. Play fake, now Fields to throw. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I wonder if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But a nice throw there for a good game and a first down.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To throw is Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney. Room here to run. run. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A big play that time on the catch and run. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Robinson's got it. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
It was a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Montgomery is not going to advance very far. He'll be stopped right at the line of scrimmage.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Once more, Montgomery.
And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all.
Third and goal, trying to make that scoreboard at least a little more respectable. Fields now to throw.
In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12.
Micah Kizer able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
Well, collectively as a defense, Charles, I think if you get 4 sacks a game, you're feeling really good. Now they have 6 as a unit.
And that type of a number is just staggering because there's so many ways to try and counteract it. But in this case, they've got no answers for this unrelenting pressure coming at their quarterback.
On is Santos for the Bears field goal.
And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And that will narrow this, if that's even the right word, to a 30-point deficit.
I'm kind of surprised by that they kicked the field goal. I guess you get some points, but this deficit third quarter, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. Yeah, I'm with you on that one. When you're down that much, kicking a field goal, does it feel a little bit maybe waving the white flag and just want to get out of here? Yeah, I think you got to go and try to get some bigger points on the board.
Get a look at this offense led by Cooper Kupp as they make their way back onto the field.
A monster game so far, third quarter. He is lighting up the stat sheet.
And so many times when you see these types of games, you hear about the quarterback, or we talk about the quarterback throwing guys open, putting it in the right spot. How about some credit for the receivers,
though?
Find ways to get open, whether they uncover late in a route or they get open early, but they just always find a way. And he's having that type of a game.
Yeah, he's been nearly impossible to cover. Well, you won't hear any boos from this home crowd on that call.
No, not at all. And it's been a long day for this crowd. Waiting for this game has been a long evening as well. Finally, they feel they got a call.
Oh, again. He's still on his feet.
Uh-huh.
And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Darrell Henderson, 43 yards. And the Rams just continue to pour it on.
So that CD, that was impressive. He got out of 3, maybe 4 tackles there on his way to the end zone.
And a lot of times when you break a tackle or slip a tackle, it actually slows you down. That's what we were taught. If you don't make the play, make him stop his feet so someone else can get there and tackle him. But not here. He just kept right on going.
Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. Here's Cohen now to return. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, that they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up.
Yeah.
Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there halftime, actually.
You think he might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now a run with Montgomery, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And this is going to be another first down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams 37. Now a give running right is Montgomery. And that play goes nowhere. He's met behind the line, and a penalty flag may add insult to injury. So that time they get the tight end on the hold.
Normally he's a pretty good run blocker, but this time he just didn't get his arms extended and let go quickly enough. The flag came out as a result.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. A give. This is Montgomery. Jordan Fuller there to take him down.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Second and 16. Back to throw. Fields. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Fair to say the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far, but a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you, but at some point, someone had to make a play and try and stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching, huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver dominated. Now, meanwhile, a final play here is incomplete, and that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of play. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They snap it to Fields. Going to let one fly for Robinson. And able to catch it, but he's out of bounds. And the throw took him beyond the sideline, and that's going to be a turnover on downs. And that makes him now 0-for-3 on fourth down attempts.
A lot of people would say they're showing a lot of guts going for it this many times on fourth down. I think they'd have to start thinking with their head a little bit more than with their gut and their emotions because it's not working for them. They've got to figure out what's been going wrong.
Airing it out deep for Woods. And oh, that nearly their first pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking.
And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A big connection on that one, 33 yards. Boy, another big play late here for offense. Charles, it certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long, and I would say that going along with that has been confidence because even if they had the right coverage, they've still dented them, and now it's been a real issue for them during this game.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. They'll buy some time right, looking for the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll run here with Henderson. Give him four on the carry there. It's second and goal. Gonna run the sweep here. This is Kupp. And diving to try to get the first down. He's gonna be a little bit shy of the marker. And give him 2 yards officially, and now it'll be third and goal. And they'll go jet sweep to try to pick it up. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Cooper Kupp. Fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Rams are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead will swell by one more. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Here's Cohen now to return. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they knew coming in that this would be a tough place to go in and win a season opener. But this has just been a performance to be... Oh, Cohen lost the football. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And he will not get all the way home, but he will take this back down to about the 2-yard line. So now our referee looking at the sideline saying, are you sure? But yes, this defense has accepted the penalty. So that means they will not take possession on the fumble recovery. I'm not sure why in the world you do that, but that is apparently the decision. So that a nice throw, but it hasn't really turned out to be the grand debut that many had hoped for. His team's down double digits. So what have you seen, CD?
About what I expected, really, because for a youngster making his first start in the NFL, I kind of expected to see these things. A few bumps along the way, maybe not the plays you expect to see or want to see. But remember, he's not going to the Hall of Fame off this first start. It's going to be an accumulation of games before we have a fully accurate reading.
Meanwhile, Fields' throw pulled in by Tate. Sean McVay, unhappy on the sidelines visibly. He's made the decision to reach for the red flag. The thing that they'll be looking at is a spot of the football, and this is always such a tough one for officials to get exactly right.
Not just because of how fast the game's going, but just trying to get the right sight line to the football, that's not always easy. We'll see what they decide here.
Sway the official's decision. Spot of the football going to remain right where it is. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. It looks like a 12-yard loss there on the first down sack.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Another try after the first down sack. Fields flushed out right. And he'll slide to a halt here. Still a little shy of the first down marker. Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. Out of the gun, Fields. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down. Here's Chris Jones now. He's been terrific so far. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. Get a look at this offense led by Cooper Kupp as they make their way back onto the field. All right, how has he done it? Four touchdowns in this contest. He's been around the end zone in particular pretty much uncoverable.
And you know that I typically take things from a defensive perspective. I'm not going to do that this time. Let's just praise him. My goodness, four receiving touchdowns means he's been a variety of coverages throughout this game because they're not just letting him run scot-free. They're trying their best to shut him down, and he's shredding them.
I got to be honest. I want to see five. Oh, you want to see five? I mean, we're not supposed to be biased, but.
We're not rude.
And that is going to be pulled in one-handed.
Wow.
A big play that time through the air. 37 yards. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for first and 10. Sliding out of the pocket.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And this is taken in at the 5. And he just falls short down at the 1-yard line. A big play there for L.A.
Even with the big lead here in the fourth, it still bounds away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They were able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
They'll roll him out right.
Again, he targets Cup, and this time he's got it.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. Now Stafford on 3rd and goal. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
And I guess not content to get another 3 here late. They'll try to add 6 more as they go on 4th and goal. They go for it on 4th and goal, but that winds up incomplete. They can't hook up here on the 4th down pass attempt, and the Bears will get the football back. Now a 1st down throw, Fields. The screen pass here to Cullen. And this one will be taken up. They'll spot it right at the 7. Not much there, only a yard. Throwing again on 2nd down. Fields. And his throw is incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Touchdown, Bears! Jarnell Mooney, 93 yards. And the Bears get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this 4th quarter deficit. Santos with the extra point as they make the score just a slight bit more respectable here in the final quarter of play. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And this is really the start to the season that you're hoping for if you're a coach or a player. They've got the big lead here in the 4th quarter, and now can really take some time off the clock. Looking for more there on 1st down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, 2nd and 10 from the 25. Stafford's throw pulled in by Woods. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Stafford now to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Henderson. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Stafford looks to throw again. Rolling to his right. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era. We think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. This is caught, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. And now they're in the hurry up to throw at Stafford. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and goal.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. Here's 2nd and goal. Throwing at Stafford. He'll buy some time right. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
All right, Captain. He's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodged 2 pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up 3rd and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
And he's got it. That's Cup for a Ram touchdown. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Rams have got it on cruise control. I think
all teams probably like seeing that schedule for the first time. Looking at week one, oh, good, we're at home. This is why you want to be home in week one. They're looking sharp.
And I agree with you totally. That's what you want. But there carries a little extra pressure with that as well, because you and I both know protecting the home field, winning your home games is paramount in this league. So you go into it, yeah, we want it, but now you actually have to go out and prove it.
Yeah, two sides to that coin, and looking like they're going to protect it here in this one. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. Here's Cohen now to return. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. David Montgomery ready to take the field for the Bears' next possession.
He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's what you're looking for if you're a back, because that means everything's coming together for you. Big guys up front have created space. You've run through it. You've probably got some help even from the wide receivers who want to catch passes as opposed to block, but they're helping out too.
Yeah, everyone's pitching in. He's had a good game. He sets to fire deep. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line. Yet another mistake after the interception there. Gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter. And some room to maneuver. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On first down at Stafford. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. DeSean Jackson with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And thanks to the interception, the Rams offense cashes in for six.
Well, they mentioned this week, Charles, they had a couple kinks on offense that they wanted to fix. I would say they're pretty well fixed.
And now, of course, all scoring plays are reviewed, and I think they're going to take an extra long look at this one. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The drive there only spanning three plays. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Here's Cohen now to return. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Bears offense out there set and ready to go. And no doubt this is not the way that they had hoped to open their season. Thoroughly outplayed here in front of the national audience. Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And a loose football. And now the Rams have got it going the other way. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
All right, you've had to put up with me in this booth. I'm going to try and be simple this time and succinct. It simply has not been their night.
No, I think that fumble's kind of indicative of how this whole evening's gone, isn't it?
Without a doubt. I mean, they've tried, but nothing has ever really taken throughout the game. That's why they're down so big.
They'll fake the give. Now Stafford.
And that almost their first INT of the ball game. Had his sights on it, but he couldn't seal the deal.
Play action. Stafford sliding out of the pocket. This is caught. It's Woods. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Here's Stafford. And it's caught. Touchdown. Tyler Higbee. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Rams use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that will extend this big lead. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. Here's Cohen now to return. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Kenny Young, his second sack of the night.
And you can say that is just another cherry on top for this defense and that entire team. But really, this defense has sparked what's been an impressive effort here in this one.
And notice you used the word sparked, because you're not seeing that on the other side of the ball, are you? The offense right now, the spark has left their game, and it's been because of what you described, that defensive pressure.
And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in. Throwing the out route, incomplete. That's Robinson. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Here's Jackson to return. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby.
L.A. set to take over again on offense.
And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. You know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's third down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this fourth quarter. And the punter's on the sideline. Here's the field goal unit now to try an exceptionally long one. This to equal Matt Prater's record. It's a 64-yard attempt. And Gay knocks this one through. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. Sports as the kick teams are out here following the 2-minute warning. After the made field goal, Gay back out there to kick it off. Here's Cohen now to return.
And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line.
the Bears offense now heading back out onto the field. Let's just be frank, they're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because
shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Maybe a frustration penalty there, because he's picked them apart.
They've tried their best to get to him and haven't done it successfully. A penalty as a result of that hit there.
Fields on first down.
And he finds his tight end, Graham. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Here's Fields.
And the Rams got it. They bring him down. That winds up pushing him back 11 yards on the sack. And that'll bring up third. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. Here's Chris Jones now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. They'll run with Henderson here to begin the drive. Fighting through, and he's got space.
125 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in the season opener.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with, and throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to, and it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. And did he just clock that? Looked like he tried to stop the clock, but the clock wasn't even moving. And they take a knee. Third and 11, and some extra depth to the secondary here. They're in the dime. And on fourth down, they come up and take the knee. A big offensive explosion leading them to victory. And the defensive guys are just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for L.A., it's a victory for Matthew Stafford in his first game as a member of someone other than the Lions.
See you. in front of you. Got my check up, and now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoes, and all designer, drink it what I desire. Put him out, what I told him, cause that boy, he on fire. Walk in that thing and air it up, and in my bag a little bit. Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't beat a little chick. They say